So, another in the middle of the night bathroom update. Simply because the bathroom is the only room where I can be alone. Or, well, yeah. As you know by now, living in a really small apartment, so bathroom it is. And I was thinking I was going to talk a little bit about my house hunting, but I'm not sure I can do that right now. Anyway, tonight I, Andrew, went to a parenting meeting at my next oldest school, and I really liked that school. It's from, I think they said 1421 or 1420, something like that. So it's a really, really old school, even for being in Sweden. And I like, you know, when you walk in the stairs, at the steps are going like, you know, like this, and like a wave. You can see there all the students during the hundreds of years have walked up and down the stairs and so on. I really like that. It's a little bit hard to walk in because it's easy to trip, but I still like them because you know, this historical connection. And this school is also a little bit different than most schools in Sweden, as it's built with money from the Vatican. It was a Catholic church, Catholic, not church, school before. It was long ago now, but still, and we don't have many of those in Sweden, especially not the older ones. So, yeah, it's really nice. But anyway, we went to this parenting meeting. I had to bring Ro because I didn't have any babysitter. And we had this big, you know, room, hearing room. There, you know, all of our gathering. And it's like a half moon shaped room. So you're sitting like in a circle, like seas, like in a theater, where you go higher and higher. And we're also a balcony, but we can sit and listen to people talking. And in the middle of this like half moon or sea, there was this stage, and a stage with a radio of like, because it was also half moon shaped, and it was a radio of like maybe 3 meters, so it's like 6 meters from one side to the other side of it. And Rue didn't want to stay in my knee, as she usually don't anymore. She wants to stay on the floor and look around and so on. And at first she was just sitting beside me and smiling and flirting with everybody, but all of a sudden she just crawled away and in under the stage. And it was crowded, so I couldn't really go after her either, and I couldn't see her. And I just could, you know, wait and see until she came out some other way. And you can look at people's smile and how they interact with each other, and how you all of a sudden, like, you know, go down on the floor. She was somewhere, but it was, I got a little bit worried, but she had a lot of fun, and it seems like a lot of other people had fun out too. She's definitely not a coward. She's a little bit too tough sometimes. But yeah, so it was a memorable apprentice meeting. And tomorrow we are going to this baby song music group for the first time, and it's like music classes for young children between 1 and 2 years. So, and as Rose 13 months old now, it's Fitzer, right, I think. So it's gonna be her first music class, and yeah, I think it's gonna be fun. It's quite early in the morning, and I'm really tired, and she has a lot of problems sleeping right now, so we'll see about that. But it was this house hunting thing I was thinking about. I started, as I told you before, I'm thinking about moving to the United States. Oh, I will apply for this job, and I will probably get it also. It won't be many major problems, because it's not just one job you can get. It's you have this chance of coming all the time, and there are not so many people who apply for it, not so many people who are who can apply for them, simply because we haven't done right studies before and so on. And I have, I asked a little lot, and and I'm thinking about before that, like after Christmas or something, like that, rent a house here in Sweden and see if we can find something, because when I start working it'd been really nice. And also looking for, not looking for actively, because it's a few years in future, this house moving to the United States, but I try to get a feeling for different areas. I was thinking, like, if I'm gonna work in Washington, DC a few times a week, I think it should be like maximum an hour and a half drive from there, which I think is a reasonable time to go for a job. Yeah, I don't want to go longer than that, but when you don't never been into an area, it's hard to get a grip for, you know, which areas are good and which are not so good, and also the prices. Sometimes it's easy if you find something you like and think that this is, you know, the price level that's common in this area, and then maybe it's way overpriced, or that way it's, maybe it's really cheap and you don't understand it, and so on. So I'm looking at different sites, at houses and people who give them out. And it's also a little bit strange, because a lot of, or maybe not strange, I guess it has to do with the economy, because a lot of houses are really expensive. As I looked for houses where before, just for fun, you know, just, but now I look at it, I'm a little bit more serious, I'm thinking a lot of them are really expensive. At the same time, the people who want to let people rent the houses, then we don't pay at all, that much at all. So I guess it's quite hard to get some houses sold simply. I don't know, I guess it has to do with the economy problem, and so on. So it's interesting to see. Also, it differs from country to country what's included when you rent a place. And like in some countries you need to get your own oven and refrigerator and things like that, and some places everything is included, even furniture and so on. So it's really it's interesting when you look at pictures from another country than you're used to. So yeah, it's really fun. And sadly I haven't found anything here in Sweden yet that I'm gonna look for, because that's more closer in time, but I'm gonna keep looking and hope I find something here, and yeah, could rent for maybe a year or two, and then we could move to US for a year or two, and after that I don't really know, but that's what I'm planning to do right now. And it's also interesting to look at different designs and styles and what's in and what's out, and sometimes you get like almost shocked, because I thought it was more international, but the trends are the same all over the world, but definitely not. Maybe in magazines, but not in people's, you know, real homes, where are a huge difference. And it seems like things which are absolutely unthinkable to have here, like, you know, you had that in the 80s, is popular in the United States, and the other way around, I guess, if someone from Jews took a look at a Swedish page, they would say, what the heck are they thinking about, you know, that was in the 90s or something like that. So it's really interesting, actually, to watch and see the differences between them. So yeah, that's what I'm being up to today. And Rose is asleep, and she has a lot of problems with her stomach right now, more than usual. It's why I'm also awake this late, because she simply couldn't fall asleep. She was just waking up after a few minutes because of all the pains and so on. And that's also something I'm going to talk about soon, I think. But I need to do that a day when she's not so much in pain, and when I feel... I'm afraid I will... Because sometimes I'm really angry about this and so on, and I don't want... to do recording when I am, because I think I would say things I might regret later on, and I don't want to be I don't want to be hurtful when I don't need to. So sometimes it's better, you know, to keep thoughts which are not that positive to yourself until you can think a little bit more clearer and more rational. And yeah, so that's what it is. Thank you for watching. Bye.